Image to image is a simple way to modify an existing image through both noise and prompting. Here's how to do this with a Z Image Turbo. Here's a straightforward image to image workflow. We take our input image through the load image node, and then we prompt it to how we might want to direct that output image to look like. So I want to have a man in an airport holding a camera. Then we can adjust this K-sampler denoise value anywhere between 0 and 1, with a higher value being more creative results and a 0 value lending more weight to this originally loaded image. So at 0.8, we then have this resulting output. So basically what's going on here is we take our input image, noise is added to it, so we can roughly see the outline of that original subject, but we really don't know if it's a man or a woman and what she's holding exactly. And then we clean that up with Z Image Turbo to create this resulting output image. So that's the basics of an image-to-image workflow task. Now, of course, it can get much more nuanced than that. So this original image was created in Midjourney, and it has that classic AI sheen, and I want this subject to look a little bit more realistic. Well, that's where image-to-image can actually be quite useful. Instead of using control nuts and adding more weight to the workflow, we can just use a simple prompt to clean it up. So here I have my prompt set of a woman holding a cup of coffee, and I'm going to turn this denoise value down to only 0.10. So only a little bit of noise is being added to this image, and then Z Image Turbo will basically run a quick pass over it. So here's our final output image. If we take a look at it a little bit larger, we can see it's nearly identical to our input image, but we can notice that there's subtle differences, particularly with the textures and the appearance of the subject when compared to the output image. And if we go between them quite quick, you can notice it a little bit easier. I'll put a link to the comparison within the description. Now, if we aren't really satisfied with these results and want a even more natural appearance, just increase that denoise value and then process the workflow again. And here is our output image compared to our original image. Now we start to notice that the textures really start to come out much more in this output image compared to our source image. And this may or may not work depending on your use case. So you'll definitely want to play around with those denoise values quite a bit until you get a result that you're looking for. Now, one advanced use case for this is, say for example, we want to reference this load image node, but we want to really adapt upon that image. Well, we could write a more detailed prompt here. In this day and age, we could use just a large language model to do this for us. So if you just go down into this auto caption optional group, I have the ComfyUI Florence 2 custom nodes. I'll put a link to this in the description. But basically it passes through this image into this node and then writes a detailed caption of this original load image node, which we can see here. All you need to do is just simply take this caption and bring it up to the clip text encode, and so now that will be set instead of our original prompt. And then let's increase this denoise value up to 0.8 and then process this workflow. All right, so here is the brand new output. We can see that this output image is completely different from our input image that we were using before. So here again is the output. We can still see it's a woman holding a cup of coffee. Generally keeps the structure of this original image, but completely reimagines it. Now, if you want to adapt upon this, you can always just keep this disconnected and copy the prompt. And then let's take this apart here and then just paste our prompt. So say, for example, you wanted to have the woman in front of a plain blue background, you can just modify that as you want. So that's how you can put together a image-to-image workflow using Z Image Turbo. Now, if you have any questions, please drop it in the comment section below. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.